Hey friends, in this video, we're gonna talk about how to create a seamless watercolor pattern in Photoshop. So let's get into it. So how do you create a seamless watercolor pattern in Photoshop? The first thing you're gonna wanna do is, if you have your watercolor painting already, I'm assuming you've either taken a picture of it or scanned it into Photoshop, you're gonna wanna crop your watercolor painting into a square. So what you can do is you can go to the crop tool, and up here where it says square, go ahead and crop it. Or the other way to do it is to create a new document. And in this case, I've created a square document that's 2500 by 2500 pixels. You can create the document into whatever size you want, but I recommend creating your document at least 2000 pixels by 2000 pixels. And this is the tile that's going to repeat across bigger surfaces. This pattern tile that we have is going to be used to create larger seamless repeats. So in this case, I'm going to create a watercolor design from scratch. And I actually have here open my watercolor brush set. There's 15 different brushes, but I actually sell them on my website. They're Photoshop brushes and they're also Procreate. So you can actually get these brushes on my website. So if you go to the gypsy goddess.com, you can go to shop Photoshop brushes and it'll bring you down here. This is actually the product right here, watercolor Photoshop stamp brushes. I've also got this version in Procreate. If you're a Procreate user, you can definitely get that version instead. So the first thing you want to do is color sample an image that you have. If you're creating a watercolor seamless pattern from scratch, you definitely want to have some colors that you've chosen. So here I've previously color sampled a reference image and I wanted to do the seamless pattern in blue and brown. The two brushes that I'm gonna use, watercolor brush 03. So let's go ahead and create a new layer. I like to put these brush shapes into separate layers. Here's our first one and we can just stamp it in the middle. We can do Command T if we wanna move it to this side here, or if we want to decrease the size, we can do that as well. So let's leave it here for now. The second brush that I wanna use is brush 02, and then this time we're going to press X. So that's going to toggle our other color to the foreground. And then now we want to make sure that this is also on a separate layer. So let's go ahead and click. And so now we've got these two different shapes. We want to think about what kind of composition we want to have. So I'm going to create something very simple. I'm just going to leave that as is. And I'm gonna take this shape and I'm actually going to increase the size just so that we have some kind of visual interest. So we'll move this shape down here. All right, so go down and choose a layer blend mode so you can see how it blends together. So if I did color burn, that shape completely disappears off. But if I duplicate that particular layer and then just go back to normal, and then what we can do is we can decrease the size of this just a little bit. So now we have something a little bit different. Let's go ahead and duplicate the brown shape. And what I want to do now is, let's say I wanted to do something a little bit bigger. I really like the way that looks. I think I'm going to keep that there. So this is kind of the basic gist of the composition that I wanted to create. In order for this pattern to repeat, we've got to add elements to the right and the left side, and also to the top and bottom. The way we can do that is, let's go ahead and pick a brand new shape and let's stamp this on a new layer. So let's do blue. And so what we'll do now is we'll figure out if we want this to repeat on the bottom and on the top. So I'll repeat the same element at the top. Let's go ahead and see what this looks like if I flipped it. Okay, no, I liked it better the other way. What I actually did is I lined up these points right at the edge, and we'll do the same for the top. So let's go ahead and duplicate this. We'll take this image, hold down shift so that you're moving it across that same line. And now the top part of the shape is going to disappear. And now we're left with the bottom piece. And so you can kind of see how this will repeat. So if we want to test this out to see if it's actually going to repeat, and let's go ahead and go to define pattern and then just click OK. And then what we'll do is create a new document, and we'll do the 29 by 29 inches, so a larger surface. And then we'll just duplicate that layer to unlock it, and then double click again. And then we'll go to pattern overlay, and then we'll go to the very bottom. So here's our pattern. And remember this bottom part here that repeats. So now we just need to fill in the shapes on the right and left side to make sure we have something that's going to repeat across. Let's go back to our original pattern tile. I want to create the shape to go left and right. Let's go ahead and fix this shape right here. So go ahead and click on it, Command T, and let's go ahead and increase the size of this. So now we'll press Command T so we can see where the middle part of this is. So what we want to do is line this up in the middle, and then we'll duplicate this layer. So let's go ahead and duplicate this layer, and then Command T, and then hold down Shift, and we'll move it to the right side. So this element is going to be repeating on the left and right side. So then now we want to fill in the top and the bottom and make sure we have something repeating. I'll go ahead and duplicate this shape right here. To vary this up a little bit, let's go ahead and flip this vertically. So now we can flip this vertically so that it'll blend right in just a little bit more. So let's go ahead and decrease the size of the shape, and then we'll go ahead and put it up here. We'll duplicate it again, and we'll bring the other piece down and line it up in the middle. And then what we can actually do is, to get a variation in this, I like to play with the opacities. I'll do 50%, and then we'll do the same thing on the bottom part of this. So we'll go to 50. And then just to give some of these shapes some variation, I'm going to change the opacity in the middle one, and we'll do 70% on this one. Let's go ahead and test this out and see if it actually repeats. So define pattern, and then we'll go back to our second document, and we'll double click the layer, and then we'll choose this one. So there you have it. So this is a seamless repeating watercolor pattern. You know, you can definitely make additional tweaks to wherever you want to make this blend in and flow a little bit more. There's so many things that you can do with it. But for the purpose of this video, I wanted to show you how you can easily do this if you want to make seamless watercolor backgrounds for Instagram stories, or you want to get this printed onto products or backgrounds or even digital wallpapers. This is the way you can do it. Or if you're trying to make watercolor backgrounds for wedding invites and you want to repeat it, that's kind of how you would do it. If you guys have any questions, feel free to reach out. So hopefully you got some value out of this video. And if you like this content, please hit the like button and subscribe to this channel. All right, guys, I'll see you next time. Bye.